Boo for that. I think it should be 4 out of 5 because I think that the game is really cool. You know, I never thought I would see a Victorious video game released this early since the pilot episode only premiered about 1.5 years ago. In the pilot episode, we heard the debut of Make It Shine. I have 2 beautiful versions of that song I'm going to be playing here for you on my playlist this afternoon. A piano version of the song, which was featured on the year beginning showcase for Victorious. That was great. That was a beautiful collaboration of that song. And the original one that is featured in the show's intro is coming up. And I want to know what one you prefer. That's going to be our poll this afternoon. Listen for that. The piano version of that. The piano tutorial was absolutely phenomenal. And I'm going to be playing that here this afternoon. Tell me which one you prefer, the original one in the intro or the piano version featured in the pilot edition of the show. Great stuff. Now, I was talking to a young man here on the show probably about 1.5 years ago. And we were talking about video games that he was selling at GameStop. One thing that he noticed was the fact that video games like the Disney ones and the Nickelodeon ones were always flying off the shelf because of the popularity of the shows and the characters that were featured on the game covers. So that leads me to believe that Victorious is going to be doing just as well. It's only been out a couple of months. One game's a bit more expensive than the other, but hey, $49.99, don't really call that an expensive game. This is not a marketing strategy or a way of me selling the game by any means. It's just a way of me putting it over and putting it on a pedestal that I think it's very deserving of being on. You're not going to pay much for this. But like I said, you know, the interactivity is there. What kid wouldn't want to enroll in a school like Hollywood Arts? I mean, it's an opportunity of a lifetime. I mean, I talked about characters. What kind of character would you portray here last week on the show? And I said, you remember what I said, kids? I said I would be the guy who does the PA announcements in the morning. That's the kind of guy I'd be. You know, the guy who comes on the PA dressed in a tuxedo like I've worn on my Facebook page for years. And do the announcements, you know, volleyball practice at 3, drama club meeting at 4:30, you know, something like that. Then I thought about it, and I said, you know, if I were to create my own character and attend Hollywood Arts, I would probably be either that, the PA announcement guy, or somebody who does a lot of stuff for theslap.com, kind of a technical engineer, does the video blog, shoots the videos, collaborates the entire website. Those are the kind of roles I would ordain myself as, or have for myself set aside. What role would you have if you were to attend Hollywood Arts? What kind of character would you portray? Do you have any characters you created on your DS cartridges or your Xbox hard drives? Let us see them. I want to see the links to them. Throw them up on our Twitter page. That could be somewhere where your character might end up. If it looks cool and you want to share it with us, I'd like to see some of your characters. I'd like to see some of the characters you've come up with on your Xbox hard drives or your DS cartridges. Because, to me, creativity is everything in this world. And, you know, I'm pretty creative. I think I am. You know, I have this web show and everything. Really, really cool web show with graphics. A variety of different things for everybody. Creative for you. I want to see how creative you can be. And with the creative player and the customization in this game, the opportunity is there for you to be creative. First thing you do in the game is create your own character. Select the person, the gender, the skin color, the hair color, the attire they wear. You can unlock clothes in the game. The opportunity to be creative is there. Channel your imagination. What kind of character would you be? What kind of role would you have? You're competing, remember, for a lead role in the year-end showcase at Hollywood Arts' big extravaganza, the big production, the big finale. What do you want to be remembered for when you go out of Hollywood Arts? Are you going out in style? Show us your character ideas, what you've created at HEW Entertainment Jonathan Clark 1. If they are cool, I'll tweet them on our Twitter page, and I might even share them in a little video on our YouTube channel. Got anything saved on your Xbox hard drives? Do you have the ability of sharing it with us? These video game consoles nowadays have YouTube, the ability to share photos and stuff. It's all apped in there. So share it with us. HEW Entertainment Jonathan Clark 1 on Twitter. follow me and join my conversation on Facebook.com, Jonathan Clark. I'm following Rex the Dummy. More on that. We're following more characters than just Victoria Justice. We are following her, too, at Twitter.com, HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark 1, Twitter.com, at Victoria Justice, and VictoriaJustice.com for tour dates, appearances, and more. Victoria Justice wrote a song originally for her sister Trina for her birth week during season 1 of Victorious. Name of the song was You're the Reason, collaborated with her friend Andre, who developed a crush on Jade in season 2. That was originally what the song was written for. Then later down the road, they collaborated it for an acoustic version, a very beautiful acoustic version, which was then turned into a love song. And the collaboration of it was so beautiful, and the shots, and the music, the piano, everything went along so well. And I fell in love with the song, and I tweeted it on our Twitter page. This is the original version of the song. Have you heard it? It's called You're the Reason, featured in Season 1 of the Victorious soundtrack. It is awesome. I'm going to play it for you here now, let you take a listen to it. Tell me what your opinion of it is. I'll talk a little bit more about the acoustic piano version after this.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
Do my own thing, and I'm starting to figure it out that it's alright, keep it together wherever we go, and it's alright, oh well, whatever, everybody needs to know. You might be crazy, have I told you lately that I love you? You're the only reason that I'm not afraid to fly, and it's crazy that someone could change me. Now no matter even care when they say you're a little bit off, looking in the eye, I say I can never get enough, cause it's alright, keep it together, wherever we go, and it's alright, oh well, whatever, everybody needs to know. It might be crazy, have I told you lately, that I love you, you're the only reason that I'm not afraid to fly.
You counted at the top of the show a beautiful acoustic version collaborated in that song, You're the Reason, a song originally written for season 1 of Victorious. The way the acoustic video was shot, the way it was collaborated, the singing from Victoria Justice, it all added up for me. It all seemed to be there. It seemed to be the video that had it for me, and that's why I tweeted it on our Twitter page, as I tweeted all the videos for all the songs you have heard over the past 2 weeks here on the show. If you don't get a chance to hear your favorite Victoria Justice song, they're all on our Twitter page. We have you covered at HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark 1. There's just something about that acoustic version of that video that I absolutely love. It's on YouTube. It's on our Twitter page. The way the video was shot, for one thing, the transitions between, you know, the piano by the beach and then transitioning from the sunset into the night with the lights. Just something about it, you know, I really liked. And then, you know, I wish we saw more of those videos collaborated by a lot of those young stars, because it is absolutely phenomenal. You know, I've talked to a lot of young stars anywhere between the ages of 13 to 25, I would say, and it seems like they have a tremendous amount of talent. The youngest one I ever spoke to was probably about maybe 14 years of age, and she had so much incredible talent, and you know, the ability to sing was there. It seemed like she had it all, and she's just waiting for an opportunity. I believe her name was Krista Nicole, and she was such a phenomenal talent, and it was beyond me why she hadn't been signed by some kind of talent agency. She was on show edition 119 of this program and was one of the youngest stars to ever appear here on the show, because she had a considerable amount of talent that I took into consideration, reviewed, and absolutely fell in love with. And people like Victoria Justice were her inspiration. She loved Taylor Swift, too. She loved Taylor Swift, Demi Lovato, and the Jonas Brothers. And she has a lot of covers of songs from them on her YouTube channel, which she takes great pride in. It's updated by herself and her father. Her father's actually featured in a lot of her music videos, too. But, you know, she's just an example of how far somebody can go when they actually put their mind to it and put their dream in action. That's a lyric from the song Make It Shine. That's coming up next here on our playlist. But she was great. You can check her out. KristaNicole.com is her official website. She's got photos up there, blogs, everything. And there are a lot more young talents I wish I could put over here on the show. You know, I keep going back to a comment that a young girl posted in one of the reviews of one of the Victorious games. She says she loves the show Victorious because it's all about performing, singing, and being what you want to achieve in life. So she loved it for that reason. And I think that's really the message that Victorious tries to convey with everything it does. You know, the music videos that Victoria Justice puts together, apart from, you know, being on the show, is great too. I think everything kind of adds up with Victorious. It seems like, you know, the way of Nickelodeon striking gold, in my opinion. You know, a lot of people will refer to things like the creative player in Victorious Time to Shine and Hollywood Art Station.